Welcome to Joniškis District Municipality, where the sweetest cherries grow. You'll find Joniškis in the north of Lithuania, bordering Latvia. It is less than 3 hours from the capital Vilnius and half the time from the capital of Latvia, Riga. Joniškis is a fairly small municipality, with a population being around 20,700 in 2020. Yet it is rich with nature, history, architecture, and it can show you all that. Let's see.
If we talk about nature, then a must-see place is Žagarė Regional Park, with an educational path in Mūša Tyrelis Thermological Reserve. It is the longest walkway through a swamp in Lithuania, reaching almost 4.5 kilometers long, going one way. Yes, we Lithuanians really like our swamps. The reserve is enlisted in Natura 2000 Protected Areas list, yet it is allowed to visit on your own, no guides needed. Just a few things to keep in mind. The swamp is home to common European adder, the only venomous snake in Lithuania. And one big rule, no smoking in the swamp, because the place is full of very flammable peat deposits. Also, be aware that swamps are inhabited by Lomir, a Baltic mythological creature with the looks of a beautiful woman. She might help you find your way, or if she didn't like you, she can cause trouble or lead you to a wrong path in the swamp altogether. Of course, that is before having modern wooden walkways in the swamps, which makes it impossible to get lost. Mūša Tyrelis swamp has its own Lomir. I heard she's friendly, so maybe she could show you around, tell you more about her life in a swamp, the traditions and myths that shroud the mythology of Lomis. Another interesting place in Žagarė Regional Park is one of the longest in Lithuania Ice Age Ridge and the historical hill fort near the town Žagarė, with a recreational, educational path going through it. It is a great place to spend an afternoon outdoors, for the park has picnic tables, fireplaces, basketball and volleyball pitches. Right next to the Žagarė Ridge is the town Žagarė itself. Being one of the oldest towns in Lithuania, Žagarė is first mentioned in history in 1254. It became quite a popular town, attracting many manufacturers, and it was flourishing in the beginning of the 20th century. The gem of town's architecture is the Palace of Žagarė from 19th century, with a park, 18th century windmill, and even a beautiful horsekeeper's house with a hippodrome nearby. The owners had a horse riding school and bred ancient Lithuanian horse breed Žemaitukas, Samogitian. Nowadays, the palace hosts Žagarė Regional Park Visitor Center, where you can learn even more about the region, its nature, culture and history. One more thing Žagarė is famous for is a cherry festival. It is said that in 18th century every household of Žagarė had to plant a cherry tree. Following this rule, Žagarė has developed a bond and traditions around the cherry tree, created their own cherry type. In this town, you can even learn how to create scarecrows. Now every year there is a cherry festival in July, celebrating the cherry growing tradition. And if you get thirsty after all that cherry sweetness, visit a local freshwater stream filled with calcium and magnesium. It is a protected natural heritage site and a part of Žagarė Regional Park. Because of the stream, a brewery was built nearby in the beginning of 19th century by owners of Žagarė Palace. It was active until the palace was lost to the Soviet government. Last but not least, when in Žagarė, it is hard to miss a one-of-a-kind gallery, pot house. The owner displays all the pots he's collected over the years on the facade of his house. And inside you can check out a small museum too, where you can find more pots and also other old things found in the region. Let's go to the district capital town, Joniškis. The town was established in the 16th century. However, then the area was still predominantly pagan, as it was a part of Samogitia, one of the last pagan places in the whole Europe. However, soon after building the town, the locals converted to Christianity. Also, many Jewish families moved in. They built two synagogues. But Joniškis wasn't a very lucky place in history. It experienced many wars. The town church was rebuilt 4 times. During World War I, almost 2,000 Jews were exiled to Russia. And before World War II, the town had just around 700 left. After Nazi occupation during the war, the town was left only with 15. The two beautiful 19th century synagogues of Joniškis were renovated in the 2000s, and now they organize events uniting local community. They also attract Jew tourists seeking to find their roots. One of the synagogues has a small museum, and the town itself has more: Joniškis History Museum, Tennis Museum, and, surprisingly, the only museum of Lithuania's most beloved sport, basketball.
All in all, Joniškis District Municipality may seem small at first, but there is a lot to uncover and explore in this ancient northern land. Thanks for watching.